Well, Jay, thank you for talking to us. We're looking ahead to this weekend. We're back in action against Preston North End, a team with that provides you with many happy memories from the start of this season, of course.
Yeah, obviously, we're going into this game off the back of two good games we've had. And looking at the start of the season when we played them, we'll still try to gel together as a team. We had a good first half, and then I think we just had to see the game through in the second half. But personally, for me, it was good to get my first league goal for Swansea.
I was going to say, what did that moment mean to you? It was a wonderful glancing header from Joel Osoro's cross, wasn't it?
Yeah, it meant a lot. Obviously, this season, it's obviously been a big season for me and a lot of the boys. So I think that was the second game into the season to get my first goal in the league. Meant a lot to me.
And the first of three you've scored this season in the league, so and the best tally that you've enjoyed in your career so far. Are you enjoying having added that goal scoring side to your game?
Yeah, it's always good to help the team out that way. Getting goals into my game as well. Up in Scotland, as you said, three was my best throughout the season, so hopefully I can go on and get a few more.
And you have in general taken on more of an attacking midfield role this season. Have you enjoyed having that freedom?
Yeah, it's just that I've had a bit more, been able to get forward a bit more. I don't know if it's maybe the system we're playing. Sometimes when I play in a three in midfield, I can go forward with knowing I've got cover behind me. But no, as most of the boys will do, whatever it is for the team, they'll play in that position.
Well, absolutely. And Preston are, of course, managed by Alex Neil, a guy that you came up against, actually, when you were playing for Falkirk. Do you have any memories of coming up against him?
Yeah, it was tough. He was seasoned pro. I think I was 17 at the time. So the game's probably my toughest games when I was up in Scotland, playing against somebody with that experience. But they type of things help you in your career.
And did those traits that he showed then, is it obvious now in the way that his teams are set up and the way that they play?
Yeah, well, he used to play in midfield and just used to organise the whole team. You could see that whenever you played against him. So I think looking from afar, you could probably see that it could go on to become a gaffer.
Well, absolutely. And speaking of gaffers, how much are you enjoying working with Graham Potter this season?
Yeah, it's been good. It's been, I think, like a breath of fresh air for majority of the boys. Training's good, there's a good feel about the place, and going into games, I think, bar maybe three or four games this season, we've done well. In the other games, it's not without a lack of trying, it just didn't work for us, the games.
And of course, we've got a much younger squad this season, the likes of Ollie McBurney, Joe Roden, Dan James, a lot of players that you've developed with yourself, you played with in the under-23s a lot this season. How much are they enjoying their chance to be playing first team football after working hard for it?
Yeah, as I said, everybody is. That's what you get into football for, to get into the first team. A lot of sacrifice has been made, a lot of hard work's been made, so now they're getting a bit of reward for it.
And from your own perspective, you've shown that you've been able to play through the pain at times this season, of course breaking your hand against Bristol City, but carrying on, and that just demonstrates the character that, well, not only that you've got, but I think that's a good little trait that's obvious in the rest of the team, isn't it? Sort of thing.
Well, wouldn't you wait that long to try and get your chance, you don't let go off with a broken thumb, do you? So, no, everybody's, as I say, everybody's there, ready to play. Obviously, there's can only be 11 on the pitch and 18 in the squad, but the whole squad's ready to play.
I was going to say there's plenty of rotation, I mean, particularly in your area of the field, there are a lot of strong midfielders in the team, but so I've no doubt you're hoping to start a few more games going forward into the second half of the season.
Yeah, well, that's all it is. You just got to be ready for your chance. Obviously, as you said, there's a lot of competition for places, and once you get your chance, you just got to try and take it.
And again, on a personal level, you signed a new deal with the club in November. What did that mean to you?
Yeah, it was good to get it over the line. We'd spoke about it for a while. And this season I've been enjoying my football, and it's something I want to stay and play.
Positive signs for the future at Swans, the likes of yourself, Connor Roberts, Joe Roden and Matt Grimes most recently all signing new deals.
Yeah, well, this season, with it being probably a lot of people's first seasons, definitely a lot of people's first season in the Championship, after this season, keep the squad together and hopefully progress from there.
And football's a huge part, been a huge part of your upbringing, Jay, because of course your father and grandfather also played. Do you feel like football's in your blood?
Yeah, well, it's all I've got two brothers as well, so it's all we've known when we've been growing up, out the back garden playing football and going to games every weekend, so it's all we've known really.
And plenty of good advice from those going along the way, I imagine.
Yeah, it helps you. Obviously, my dad's had experience of being in a football environment, so any knowledge that he can pass on to me always helps.
And we're back on the road, obviously. You know, we're in good form at the moment with the results against Reading and Aston Villa in the Cup, so trying to carry on building on that momentum, I've no doubt.
Yeah, well, that's what it is. I think probably the last two games is we've had comfortable scores in the end, so hopefully with the confidence in the team, we can take that another step forward.
So is it just about trying to establish that sort of consistency now? Because we see we've got the quality within the squad. It's just maybe stringing that run of wins together. Do you think that's just what we need to do now?
Yeah, I think we need to maintain the level that we've shown the last two games. And I think the chances when we get them, the last two games we've took them, whereas before maybe not took them and made a game harder for ourselves. But all we can do is take each game as it comes and try to build on it.
Well, absolutely. And looking forward, again, on a personal note, you're approaching 50 appearances for the Swans in all competitions. A good milestone to reach.
Yeah, these sort of milestones are always good to reach. Shows you that you're obviously doing something right. So hopefully it can come around quick and start looking on to the next one.
And what will it mean to you to reach that milestone, obviously? Swansea, a place where you've been for a little while now, and this season you're starting to really establish yourself, if you like, getting regular opportunities.
Yeah, that would be a good thing. Obviously, this season I've been able to clock the appearances up a lot quicker, but it's just something that shows the hard work that you've been doing behind the scenes is paying off.
Well, absolutely, and by the time you get to 50, I've no doubt your eyes will just be more and more and more will be the target.
Yeah, well, it's just a number, and you want to get more. You just want to be on the pitch, try to help the team.